Welcome back! My name is ballerscuba. This is Video Games Over Time! We are still in 1983. Today, we're going to talk about Spy Hunter. The story of Spy Hunter takes us back to Bally Midway. We have talked about Bally Midway several times before. The American publisher was responsible for both Ms. Pac-Man and the Tron arcade game. The idea for Spy Hunter came from George Gomez. George Gomez had worked on Tron. Gomez drew inspiration from the James Bond franchise, specifically from the music from the films. Originally, the video game was supposed to be a licensed James Bond video game, but Bally Midway could not afford the rights to the license. Instead of having James Bond music, the game would have an arrangement of the theme song to the television show Peter Gunn. Peter Gunn was a private eye TV show that aired between 1958 and 1961. The original theme was composed by Henry Mancini. The sounds of the game would be developed by Bob Libby, Michael Bartlow, and Neil Falconer. Tom Leon would assist with the design of the game as well. Leon worked with George Gomez on the Tron arcade game. Spy Hunter is a vertically scrolling driving game. In the game, the player plays as a spy that drives an armored sports car. The player drives down a freeway, destroying as many enemy vehicles as possible while protecting the civilian vehicles. The player's car can be destroyed by enemy weapons, a hard collision with another vehicle, or going too far off the path. The player can earn more lives after earning enough points. The player can reach new levels with different weather and terrain by going through forks in the path. However, the game is endless and has no final level. The car can be upgraded by going into a weapons van. The weapons van can be summoned by pressing a blinking weapons van button, which will reset in each new territory. The car can also get special weapons. Those special weapons include oil slicks, smoke screens, and surface-to-air missiles. The car can also be transformed into a speedboat when the road is traded for a waterway. Spy Hunter was released by Bally Midway to American arcades on June 11, 1983. They would also release the game to European arcades in 1983 and Japanese arcades in 1984. That is the short backstory to Spy Hunter. With that now told, it's time to play the game for ourselves. And here we are in the game. This is Spy Hunter, copyright 1983 by Bally Midway, as we talked about before. Now, this is going to be a complicated game, so we're going to let all this play out, and we will try to explain it as we go along. We have the enemy agents, we have the Road Lord. It's a bulletproof bully worth 150 points if you are able to destroy it. But you notice that the demo is not particularly good at taking out the enemies either. I'm not going to be good at this at all. Switchblade, never to be trusted, my least favorite enemy, because they sneak up behind you, they have those going for them, and they just knock you off the road so quickly. Next up we have the Enforcer, double barrel action. They have a double barrel shotgun and they will shoot at you. They're worth 500 points if you're able to defeat them, but the demo was not. And finally, we just have one more enemy coming our way. We have the Mad Bomber. This is the Master of the Sky, meaning it's a helicopter. And it launches a bomb at you. Not only will the bomb kill you, that pothole will kill you if you hit it. We are technically in the G-1655, I believe, Interceptor. It is not the sturdiest of spy vehicles. Avoid all other cars and motorcycles. Those are all civilians. To be honest, they have no business being on the road right now. You get points for traveling. You get points for continuing to drive forward. So you basically get points for your distance traveled. But killing a civilian will temporarily disable how many points you're getting by traveling at all. First stage of the game runs on a timer with unlimited cars. After the timer expires, additional lives will be awarded for points earned at 30,000, 60,000, 90,000, and 120,000. I'm not sure that's going to happen for us today. Like I said, my high score is that one there. It took me a while to figure out how to get my initials to show up. You can see I also have the fifth highest score. We're going to do what we can. The original game was complicated. It had a complicated setup. Not only did you have something called the yoke, which was something much more similar to planes, but it had that set up instead of a steering wheel, and then it had a whole bunch of buttons, I believe 6 different buttons, and a pedal. So it's difficult for me to replicate that on the setup that I have, but we're going to do what we can as the intro finally plays for us, and then it stops. Alright, so we're going to try to do what we can. This is not only a complicated game, it's a hard game. It requires a lot of split-second timing. So, I'll try to explain it as we go along. Am I not able to get out of this? Start. There we go. Jeez. Start. Alright, so you have to start on low gear. You cannot start your vehicle without that. And you notice that we have the timer at the start. That's where we have the infinite lives. We can also speed up a little bit. I try not to do that, especially early on here, because touching anything while in high speed is instant death. Apparently, I went off the road. They bumped me off the road, it looks like. Not the best start, but hopefully we can recover from that. There's a lot of slicks on the road. I'm not sure who maintains this road. It's very smooth, but it needs to be, like, mopped or something every once in a while. All right, we'll take you out, and I guess we'll go right here at the fork. Doesn't really matter which choice you go down. It just basically changes the terrain. But we chose right, and now we're on a different terrain. All right, let's speed up to try to beat these guys. And there is a weapons van. You have to speed up to get inside. It looks like smoke screens for me. I do like smoke screens. Once again, you have to start on low. They won't let you start without that. All right. Smoke screen! You get 3 uses of it. Smoke screen! I'm supposed to speed up to go faster, but it doesn't always help me. Because I die when I speed up. Alright, my timer's about to run out. How many lives do I have left as a result of this? Yeah, you have to be careful going too fast. I have 1 life left. And that's not the best. Okay. Defeated you. We have missiles coming our way. Really? Really? Okay. It came out of nowhere and hit me, and I lost all my stuff. All right, let's go a little bit faster. We have the helicopter. It did fire at us, but we were able to avoid it. Nope. All right, that's it. That's the game. Like I said, it requires a lot of split-second timing here. All right, ranking is number 4. You have to hold the button down for a while to get your to get the car to move, and then it's the missile button in order to actually put in, come on, there we go, actually put in the initial. It took me forever to figure it out. I was hitting all the buttons. I didn't think of hitting missile. All right, so that's a fairly decent run, but yeah, you get 1 life, extra life, if you make it to 10,000 points. I believe you have to get to 18,000 points in order to get a second life. So, it is difficult. There we go. Let's try again. See if I can't beat my previous high score, but I'm not going to hold my breath too much about it. Well, I destroyed him. Like, yeah, bumping into people is an option, but it's not especially recommended. I'm trying to go for more points here. I'm trying to go for the 18,000, but I'm not sure I'm going to be able to do it. I haven't been able to do it yet. Yeah, and then it it just, the road just gets too narrow and it's too scary for me to go at high speed. But I'm trying. All right, high speed. Working out okay so far. All right, try to get past him. There we go. No, went off the road a little bit. Like, as soon as you touch the side of the road, it just kind of careens off. Like that. Things aren't going well for me here at all. No. Tried to get around him. At least I got my one life. Like, having unlimited lives makes me a little bit reckless to start here. But man, this game does require very specific timing. All right, try to avoid that. Like, even touching it is death. We have a very fragile spy car. All right, let's get the oil slicks. Oil slicks are supposed to be the best weapon in the game. All right, one life, there's the oil slick. There we go. Got rid of the switchblade behind me. Okay, now we have smoke screens. We can have multiple things. I was so focused on the things behind me that I didn't avoid the thing in front of me because in my mind, he was dead. All right. No! What happened? Oh, I got stopped because I went into high gear and then I got hit and that's apparently the end of that. Okay. Okay, smoke screen. There we go. You have to kind of speed up to get in there. Otherwise, the thing will take forever for you to get inside. All right, we're down to our last life, but we have officially gotten, well, there we go. We got a high score if I hadn't already done something better, but our ranking is number 2 as a result of that. This game is stressful. It just feels like you work so hard and then you just don't anticipate one small thing and then you're screwed. I think I got... No, well, okay, that's not what I wanted. Come on, there. And yet it takes forever for it to actually move. There is such a delay there. All right, we'll try one more time. I think I got one more in me, but this is a difficult game. It requires so much of a learning curve, and it requires so much just split-second timing. But I was able to get the... high score, at least what it would have been had I not already done a little bit better. But we can try again to try to get the 18,000. I don't know if it's better for me to try to do it on fast speed, but that's what I'm going for. I destroyed the motorcycle. No! Again, I just kind of touched the end, and if you're going too fast, that's the end of it. If you're going full speed, even on low speed, you're just screwed there. There, gotcha. Jeez. Okay. Over here. Thought I had slowed down, but apparently I had not. Like I said, I'm pretty reckless when there's the timer going. Thought I did technically hit the button just a little bit late. All right, I saw you. Okay, we'll get the oil slick. Oil slick is very directional though. I have to be right behind you. I kind of like the smoke screen a little bit better. I was told that the oil slick was the best though. so I must not be using it right. I got hit twice, like... feel like the civilian car moved a little bit. But I could be mistaken about that. Alright, nope. What? Okay, can I... yes. Thank you! Oil slick acquired again. It wasn't directly behind me. Alright, my timer ran out. Now I have to go like 10,000 without anything. Nope, there we go! Oh. We're gonna keep going. So the oil slick, it did actually... nope! Nope. It moved because of the pothole, and therefore I lost. And I got 10th, but I think that is gonna do it for me. I'm not gonna be able to outdo what I did before. I had some sort of lucky streak on that. So let's put in my initials for the piddly 10th one. But this game is, like I said, it's complicated and it requires a lot and a single go from you. It's difficult to replicate, and that's probably the issue. If I was probably doing it in the arcade, I might be a little bit better. Maybe. But that is the game now played, so with the game played, let's talk about how it holds up today. Playing the game today, the game is definitely fun. It is a game that not necessarily you can pick up and play because it is difficult and can be frustrating at points, but it's fairly easy to understand as long as you have the controls understood. The shifting between low and high gear, all the different weapons, all the different buttons and where they're laid out, all that kind of stuff kind of needs to be known in order to play the game well. And that's going to take some time to learn because you don't have a lot of time to react. You see an enemy at the bottom, you better hit that button for the smoke screen or the oil slick. We didn't get really a chance to see missiles, but we got to show off at least the animation for them. The gameplay is difficult, and that is the most memorable thing for me about the game, is that it is a difficult game. And some of that is due to the setup that I have, some of it's due to the fact that I'm not necessarily the best action-oriented gamer, but nonetheless, to somebody that is new to video games or somebody that has not played this particular video game before, this game's going to come across difficult to them. So there is that going for it and going against it. It's going to be a little bit harder for your more casual fans to get into, but for people that are fans of that style, they're going to spend additional time and additional quarters trying to get better at this game. That's not necessarily the way that I look at games, but there are a lot of people out there that do look at games like that. The more difficult, the better, because I want to get better at this difficult game. In terms of the gameplay holding up over time, I think it does hold up fairly well. I think that the split-second timing that you need is probably the part that didn't hold up the best, simply because there's so many options for you going on that having that quick of reaction time is not going to be something that everybody has. But overall, I think the gameplay did hold up well. The graphics, I think, also held up very well. Everything looks like what it's supposed to. We have kind of this endless scrolling road that's going at a very fast speed and done from a top-down perspective in a way that we have not seen too often. We have seen the top-down perspective, we have seen vertically scrolling, but not at this speed. Also, the combination of a driving and a shooter game that were very popular at the time is also something that we have not seen before, and I think this integrated the two very well. In terms of the sound, this sound might be among the best that we have heard in an arcade game to this point. Not only do we have the memorable background music, which granted came from a TV show, but they adapted it for this game, and that is something that is going to be well, it's going to be remembered by the people that played. It's memorable. We also had machine guns that sounded like machine guns, explosions that sounded like explosions. Everything worked in this game when it came to the sound, and that's not something that we've seen too much of in any of the games that we have played. So the sound for me is definitely a standout. So gameplay, graphics, sound, they all held up well, and they're all really good for the time. So this is a game that, although it is difficult, I would recommend for people to go back and play. It's going to take some time, it's going to cause a little bit of frustration, but this is an excellent game for 1983. So I do recommend it for anybody that is interested in racing games, in shooting games, and especially anybody that's interested in video game history at all. Spy Hunter is a good game worth checking out. And that's my modern take on the game. When the game was released, Spy Hunter proved to be popular. The game would have longevity at the arcades, becoming one of the highest grossing arcade games of 1984, and reportedly the most played arcade game of 1985 in the United States. Critics at the time were also positive about the game. Based on the game's success, Bally released a pinball version of the game in 1984. The game would become popular enough to reach the mainstream, becoming featured in film and television. The game would also see ports, sequels, and re-releases. We will keep an eye on these as we continue. With another success on their hands, Bally Midway would continue to be a big name in American video game publishing. We will hear from Bally Midway again. As for George Gomez, he would leave Bally Midway in 1984 to work on toys. However, we will hear from George Gomez again in the future as well. That will do it for the story of Spy Hunter for now. My name is ballerscuba. This has been Video Games Over Time. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in our next video when we get animated.